Hello students, so we are now studying the last topic of extended year feature, that is called aggregation. So we studied other points about extended year features, which are specialization, generalization, attribute inheritance, etc. In aggregation, the main drawback of ER model is we cannot express the relationship among relations. So I will first of all explain the definition of aggregation. Aggregation is a process in which a single entity alone is not able to make a sense in a relationship, so the relationship of two entities act as one entity. So I know that it will be very difficult to understand this point if you are reading this aggregation definition. So with the help of one example, I will explain. Suppose that there are two entities we can see here. The first one is called employee and the second one is called project. So you can take a company as an enterprise. Two entities we are taking. The first one is the employee and the second one is the project. So we know that the relationship between, there exists a relationship between the employee and the project. That is, the employee may be work on a project. Okay. So first we took two entity set in an enterprise, a company. The name of the first entity set is employee. And the second entity set is project. And we know that every employee, and there may be relationship between every employee in an organization and a project. He may be working for a particular project or he may be working on a particular project. So the relationship here we took is the works on. Then we know that there will be a manager who manages the employee. Actually, what is the task of the manager? The manager is a person. Or he is an employee who will take care of both the employee and the project. So he has to control the employee and he has to manage the project also. So how we will draw the figure? In order to explain the figure, what we will do is, suppose that if you are separately making a connection from manager to employee, it will be useless because he has to manage the project also. So in the same manner, if the connection or the relationship is made from manager to project, it is also meaningless because he has to manage the employee also. So actually the manager has to employ both the employee and the manager has to manage both the employee and the project. So here we can use the concept of aggregation. So how we will use the aggregation? First of all, we will take the relationship that exists between the employee and the project as a single module. We can manage that is as a single part. So here we will take the employee and project, and the relationship between them is works on. And to the entire module or to the entire content, the entire entity, that is this relationship act as a single entity. Okay, so to this entity, the manager is connected using a relationship that is manager's. So when you draw this figure, its meaning is that manager has to manage the entire employee and the project. Okay, so that is the meaning of aggregation. That is, you will aggregate this relationship. So here the meaning is that instead of these two entities, we are just imagining it as a single entity which contains both the entity set along with the relationship. And the entire thing, the entire entity sets are considered as a single entity set whenever we are connecting this with the manager using the relationship managers. Okay, so now the point will be clear. Aggregation is a process in which a single entity alone is not able to make a sense in a relationship. That means if you connect or if you make a manager relationship with employee alone, it is meaningless. If a manager is managing the project alone, it is also meaningless. So that is the point. So the relationship of two entities act as one entity. So here these two entities act as a single entity. We are combining this relationship which exists between these two entity set as a single entity, and then we try to connect it with other entity called manager here. So we can see another example also. Suppose this is a second example, and here it's a ternary relationship. That is, this is a relationship that is between these three entity set. The first entity set is the instructor with this attribute. The second is the project. It also has certain attribute. And the third entity set is the student with this attribute. And the what may be the relationship, what may be the name of the relationship, we can call it as a project date. That means if you take an example of an instructor, a project and a student, what is the meaning? The instructor may be the project guide of a particular student on a particular project. Suppose that here we are taking a concept that suppose the instructor guiding a student has to create a monthly evaluation report. That is, the instructor who is guiding a particular student on a particular project has to make a monthly evaluation report. So how we will use the concept of aggregation? So for that purpose, we are using a fourth entity set. We can call it as an evaluation. Okay, we can call it as an evaluation report with the ID evaluation, primary key evaluation ID. We know that every instructor will have, normally whenever we are thinking, we know that every instructor will have multiple students, many students will be there, and each of the students may be doing different project. So he has to make, suppose I am a teacher, I am an instructor, and I am guiding 5 students, and the each student are doing individual projects. Actually, I want to create 5 evaluation report for each and every student. Okay. So, we are taking a fourth entity, that is the fourth entity set, that is the evaluation report, which has an attribute. We will set it as a primary key, that is the evaluation ID. So, how we can do the aggregation here? So, this is the figure for that. So, this instructor, project and student, they are connected by using the relationship project guide. So we will aggregate this one. The entire thing will act as a single entity. And to this entity, the fourth one, that is that entity we already created, is the evaluation. So we create evaluation as another entity, and this will be evaluate for the entire thing. We know that evaluation we need to do which contains all this entity set. That is, an instructor has to make it, that may be make it for a particular project and for each student. Okay, so this the entire thing act as a single entity, and to this entity the evaluation is connected using that relationship, that is called the evaluation form. Okay, and that is the concept of aggregation. So I think it is clear now. Aggregation, what is the meaning of aggregation? And I took 2 different examples for aggregation. The first one is between the employee, project and the manager. And the second one is the instructor, project and the student. And then to the evaluation also, to this entity set also. So this is the concept of aggregation. That is, we will group a particular relationship that exists between different entities set as a single entity. Suppose this is only possible if this combination has a sense.